how to set up your microphone on your Apple Mac. Also, if your levels of the microphone is too low, or certain applications like Zoom or Keynote or something like that won't actually allow you to use your microphone. We'll cover each of those step by step. The first thing you need to do, and it's a really simple one to do, if your microphone isn't working, actually check to see if it's switched on. Make sure it's not on mute. Silly little things, but I've done that before. Also check if you've got a USB mic, if there's a gain on there, if the gain has been turned down, which would make your mic less sensitive. So just make sure the gain is at the appropriate level. Another thing worth checking is your USB lead. If you unplug that, try it in another port, or ideally try your microphone on somebody else's machine just to make sure it's working. So if you've done the obvious, check that the microphone is obviously plugged in, it's not on mute, the gain level's at the appropriate level, and also the lead and the microphone works. If you are plugging the microphone into an external device, so it's not plugging straight into the computer, it's likely that it needs to go into a powered hub. So you can get USB extensions where you get two or three extensions from one, but some of those aren't powered. Your microphone is likely to need power, so make sure it's a powered hub or a powered USB extension. That way, that might solve your problem. If you're still having no joy, it's likely now to do with settings. So what we'll do is, if we go to the Windows icon, go to System Preferences, we're looking to go to Sounds. Now, if you first go there, you might see it on this settings. So if you go to the right, click Input. So I've got three devices plugged in. The webcam, the internal microphone on that one is really minute. So the sensitivity on that isn't as high as a more professional microphone. It can do a good job of picking it up, but it needs to be closer to the person ideally. So this input volume, just make sure it's not all the way down, which would in effect mute it. Now you can't do that on all the devices, just in some microphones, and in this case, this webcam. So ideally you want it in the middle. That microphone's about a foot and a half away from me in the webcam, and it's picking me up quite clearly. So this external device, the Scala, is an audio interface, and the sensitivity of that is actually controlled on the device. But as I speak, you can see this move, the volume level meter, input level meter, moving up and down. So I know this works as far as the software is concerned. So if you've gone through here and you can see that your microphone is moving up and down, so the settings are working, the next thing to do is check the application you're using is being given permission to actually use your microphone. 9 out of 10, if you've gone through all the other options, it's likely to be this. So to solve that problem, to check if your application has got permission to use your microphone, go to the Apple icon, System Preferences. We're looking for privacy and security, or security and privacy. Whilst that's loading, I've also got videos coming up to help you grow your business using all aspects of the internet, things like live streaming, website SEO, YouTube tips. So tap the subscribe button now so you don't miss out when we upload those videos. If you click on that, again, it might go to the general icon. We want to go to the privacy. Now, I've just updated Keynote. Now, Keynote now allows you to use your microphone and camera, and it did prompt me asking me if I'm going to give it permission. I said no, which then means the next time I open it, it could be weeks later, I might have forgotten that I didn't give the software permission to use my microphone, and then I'm trying to wonder why I can't access it. So if I scroll down, first in cameras, I may as well, I'm here. So here you can see in cameras, these are different programs that want permission. So Keynote wants permission, so I'm just going to tick that. The other thing is microphones. Now you can see, or if it's grayed out, those are software or applications that would like access to your microphone, but you haven't given it permission. So if I click that view, another thing to look at, if you're using Zoom or Teams and you're doing it through the browser, depending what browser you're using, that browser would also want permission. So if you're struggling with things like Zoom and that on your microphone, it might be that if you're doing it through web browser, not through the native app, all you need to do is give Chrome permission to use, or Safari permission to use your microphone. So if you tick that, I've just done this. If you're trying to do that, it won't allow you in, this little lock here. If you click that, it might ask you to put your PIN number in, or if it's set through your watch, you may have to just confirm that you can change the settings. But basically, unlock that, change the settings you want. So select the application that you're given permission to use your microphone and or camera, and that should solve your problem. Tell you what would be really useful, if you could tell everybody what your microphone problem was. Was it software settings? Was it permissions? Or was it the actual microphone itself? Leave in the comments, it'll be worth knowing what people's microphone challenge actually were.